Hi, this is Veronica from ROEST, and in this video, I will walk you through the entire live roasting session with the ROEST sample roaster. For this video, I want to show you automatic roasting on ROEST, which makes the roaster easy for everyone and saves you time for other tasks. I already turned on the roaster and let it preheat, so let's charge the beans to start roasting. With ROEST, you can roast from 50 to 200 grams per batch. I'm using the profile based on the inlet temperature, and my batch size is 150 grams. And for this video, we are roasting washed Ethiopia. As you can see, ROEST can be fully automated, following the profile from start to finish without any interaction with the machine. After you charge the beans, as you see, you don't need to touch anything and you can focus on other tasks. You can prepare different samples, cup coffees, or even do your emails. Now let's take a look at both screens. On the left side, you can see what is happening on the touch screen. And on the right side, the web portal, showing you live data in progress. Web portal is a web-based application that comes with a ROEST sample roaster free of charge. You can access it with your credentials via this website. You need to have your roaster connected to Wi-Fi to see live data. Web portal has many great features besides live view, profile creation, log storing, analyzing logs, cupping, inventory, or public profile library. For more information about the web portal, see the link below in the description. Now let's take a look at all the curves on the live view. The green line is the inlet temperature and the green dashed line is the target profile we aim for. The blue dashed line is the target fan settings of our profile and the light purple dashed line is the target RPM of our profile. The model we are roasting on is the ROEST L100 Plus, which has all 5 temperature sensors. We can see all the temperature progress, including a blue line for air temperature, dark red for bean temperature, dark purple is the drum temperature, and the black line is exhaust temperature. Another data showing on the graph is the rate of rise, and on the lower graph, you can see the power input adjusting throughout the profile to match the target inlet temperature. There are also several events marked with the vertical yellow lines throughout the roast. The turning point is marked when the bean temperature starts rising. Yellowing is triggered when the bean temperature reaches the predefined settings for yellowing. On the top left corner of the graph, you can set the name of the batch, weight, and type of the beans. At around 190 degrees, the first crack is approaching. ROEST has an automated first crack detection that automatically listens to the cracks and registers the first crack event. Here you can see the individual cracks being detected as red vertical lines. On the touchscreen, there is counter as well. When the fifth crack is marked, the first crack event is registered and the roaster starts automatically the development countdown. Amount of the cracks to register the first crack event are adjustable from the touchscreen settings. When the countdown is over, beans are automatically released and you are ready for the next batch. It takes about 90 seconds to fully cool down the beans. As you can see, the roaster has automatically started the between batch protocol to reset the thermal energy. For more information on between batch protocol, follow the link in the description. Thank you for watching.